All right, thank you. I'm Rob Farnsworth. Thanks for letting me come today. I have sort of a new speech. In fact, I need the podium. I don't have it quite memorized yet. I'll tell you who I am first. I'm the special ed teacher from Hibbing that's running for governor. I live there with my amazing wife, Jamie, and our three children, Hannah, Isaac, and Abigail. And today I'm going to talk about something a little different than what you're used to hearing. Originally, before conventions, I was going to talk about, you know, the normal reasons why you should support me, the same speech that I've given 100 times before. But something sort of has been on my heart for the last few months, and so that's what I'm going to talk about. So, I'm not going to talk much about myself or my campaign, so go to robfarnsworth.org to learn more. Check out the picture of with the flyer on your chair with my amazing family on it. So here we go. As we've traveled around the state, all of the candidates have been asked a variation of the same question, and that question is something like this. Such and such is a problem in Minnesota. What will you do as governor to fix it? Now, this isn't a bad question. We have problems and we want them fixed. And we all give, you know, pretty much the same answer. We'll all reform education or I'll get rid of light rail. And these are good things, but they sort of miss the mark. And sometimes we get a little bit closer when we say something like this. We say the government isn't the answer. A free market is the answer. Now, that comes close, but it still doesn't quite get us where we need to be. Have you ever heard anybody say it'll take a miracle to fix that? It'll take a miracle, you know, to end abortion? I have, so why don't we think about that in those terms politically? The answer to the problems that our state is facing is not the government. It's not even the free market or free people working to their full potential. The real answer to the problems that our state is facing is much greater than that. In 1863, at the height of the Civil War, Abraham Lincoln said this. He said, "Nevertheless, amid the greatest difficulties of my administration, when I could not see any other resort, I would place my whole reliance on God, knowing that all would go well, and that he would decide for the right." Yes, I'm going to talk about God if you don't like it. Free country. Plug your ears, I guess. We're members of a party that elected somebody president just 6 years after our founding, which in itself is amazing. And I don't think it's a coincidence that we selected as our first Republican candidate for president, or our first Republican president, second candidate, a man who was willing to seek the wisdom of Almighty God. And as a party, we need to stop forgetting this. This should be the first thing that we look for in our leaders. We are imperfect. Well, the other guys are imperfect. We all make mistakes, but we can all seek divine wisdom. A lot of politicians make promises about what they're going to do. We're all going to reform education, and that's great. But the reality is, there's no guarantee that we're going to be able to do what we say we can do. That's another question that a lot of people ask as we travel around the state. How can you guarantee that you're going to do what you say you're going to do? And I understand the question. People want to believe that the person they're voting for is going to do what they say they're going to do. But too often, voters accept at face value a promise that they know can't be kept. So today, I'm going to give you just one promise. And it's a promise that I know I can keep because it relies only on me to make sure that it gets done. I can't promise to reform education. I can't promise to get rid of light rail, get rid of the Met Council, or reform welfare. I'd like to do those things. I'll fight for those things. But I'll make no empty promises that rely on more than my personal ability to act. What I can promise you is this, and this is what every governor candidate should promise you. As your governor, every day I will seek divine wisdom from Almighty God over every decision that I make. Just like Lincoln, as he led our nation through the greatest challenge we faced, I will place my whole reliance on God. I don't know about you, but I'm tired of being told to keep my faith out of politics, and I'm not going to do that anymore. Scripture says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, maybe 10,000 abortions last year in Minnesota, then I will hear from heaven, I will forgive their sins, and I will heal their land. This is the answer to the question, how will you fix our problems? I can't, but I can seek the help of the one who can. Now, as you seek your endorsed candidate, I don't want you to vote for me because you believe in God and I'm brave enough to stand up here with cameras and talk about him. I hope that you can believe that I'm sincere, that I will fight for everything that we know is right and good. But at the end of the day, I'll make no promises but one. Each morning before most Minnesotans get out of bed, you'll have a governor who earnestly prays on your behalf and seeks the healing hand of Almighty God in our state. All promises aside, that is what will fix the problems in our state. Thank you, God bless you, and God bless the great state of Minnesota.